So in the previous video was cut slightly towards the end. It was the last half a minute or so. I think that what I was saying, that that Apple doesn't force people to use the products it has, and it doesn't really subvert standards to the point where people really have to stick to the standards and pay patent tax and things like that. And this is the reason I don't really want to try and use illusionary type of drawbacks and points against Apple, which are just completely true. And I think I'll stick to the main 2 points, which I have a few sort of seconds to think about. So the first thing that the patents, as I mentioned, I'll try to be very factual here. Apple's got at least two lawsuits against Android makers and Android integrators, manufacturers, whatever you want to call it, because Android is just software from Google, and to license this software, you don't really have to pay anything, as far as I can tell. So Apple is suing these companies, and it's trying to embargo them in the United States as a means of trying to put some financial strangulations to prevent the lack of so-called compliance with patent law in the United States, even though those companies are mostly like based in Asia, where the law is kind of ambiguous on the issue of software patents. So Apple is using these monopolies to basically get its way and to limit the competition in some ways that is very harmful to the customers. And I'm not going to talk about, like, you know, things like, you know, how much money Apple makes, and I'm not going to talk about the fact that it's trying to, you know, force people to think like drones, and well, although I am going to speak about it in the next video. I'm not going to delve into like words like fanboys and so on, you know, all those words that I used to demonize and to belittle every person who stands up for Apple, because some people do have reasons to stand up for Apple, and that's fine, but I'm drawing the line somewhere. So Apple is the patent aggressor, and in the next video I'll try to explain what I mean by the marketing drawbacks and why it's bad for the consumers and why it's bad for free software in general, those who actually advocate the control by the developers and the users of the phones.